guys. Welcome to Bartlett Lake today. I've got a special guest with me, you know.
Oh, yeah.
Mr. Copperstate himself, you know.
What's up, guys?
So, David. And we're going to go out and do some fishing today, and we're going to talk about the baits we're using. We're going to show the baits we're using. Of course, everybody's going to see where we're fishing. All right? So, by the way, while I was telling him about how to fish a bait, I hooked one. So, let me get this one. I don't know how big it is, but it's just a little pound and a halfer.
Little guy.
So, just a little guy. But that happens to me when I'm guiding, too. It's, you know, I'm telling you. Because David was saying, well, what's the bite? How do I reel this in? And, boy, good gosh. How come they don't never hook themselves like this one in a tournament?
Right.
They always come off, you know. So, what I was telling David is you throw it out to the bank. I'm using a skinny wire spinnerbait.
Yep.
And you're using a chatterbait?
Yep. Yeah, jackhammer.
Jackhammer. So, that's a good bait to use. You throw it out to the bank. And David was asking, well, how is the retrieve? The retrieve is everything behind these things, jackhammers or spinnerbaits or whatever. Throw it out. Within a foot or two of the bank, you're going to get bit.
Yep.
Within 5 feet, then all of a sudden, you got to let it drop.
Mm-hmm.
Because the sun's out. We've got a late start today. It's 8 o'clock after 8. There's no wind. It's perfect for filming.
Right.
And then I let it drop down, and then I just slowly reel it in.
Yep.
And they'll hit it hard. They'll hit it. So anyway, come along with us today, and I hope you learn something. I'm using a skinny wire. You're using a jackhammer. So
absolutely.
We'll see what they're biting on.
Yeah, we'll
all
see.
Right? All right, let's continue down the shoreline. So you're aiming for different things, like try the end of this big rock out of the water, a foot off of it, yep, and then you just kind of slow that thing down. Folks, on my spinnerbaits, what's working now is because the water, look how dirty the water is today, David. It's only about three, 4 inches visibility. And
pretty murky.
So I put a copper blade on and one silver blade, all right? So just to combat that, and a chartreuse and white blade. So,
well, you got a copper color blade on there?
Yeah, see, well, because of the water, the flash.
Yeah.
So I'm giving them a little bit, I don't know if Jay can see this. I'm going to put this up by you, Jay, just to kind of get a good look at it, okay? Now, since the sun's out, fish have no eyelids, right?
Right.
So as the sun comes out, they'll drop lower in the water column. So that's our way of thinking, human way. So it works for me.
Gary, what trailers are you like using?
You know,
spinnerbaits.
You know, I get that question all the time about trailers. Let me tell you my take, and everybody could probably differ.
Right.
Because we can only see 3 inches down, I don't even use a trailer.
Okay.
That's the difference. I like using trailers when the water's clear.
Okay.
You know, and then I don't even have to use a trailer in dirty water because they're not really seeing the trailer. They're just hitting those blades.
Right.
And they're sucking that whole thing down. So
makes sense.
That's my take on it, you know. But I do use trailers in clean water, but right now, Bartlett is not clean.
But no.
It really isn't.
Definitely
and
not.
If you go up the lake, you might get a foot or two visibility.
Yeah.
So the rule of thumb is with bass, if you can see that bait a foot down, which I lost sight of it at a foot. So we're seeing 6 inches.
Correct.
So every foot that you can see your bait down, that bass can see it 5 feet away.
Yeah.
That's a lot.
Right.
And if they can't see it, they're feeling it on that by the lateral line,
right,
that black line, you know, so
the vibration.
So a lot of the new anglers, I have a lot of new people watching, kayakers, the shore fishermen, aluminum boat people, you know, like stuff like that.
Do you typically just fish the willow blades, or you ever do a willow Colorado?
I do. I started making some little Colorados now. They started hitting them, and I got some, you know. Especially if we were going to find some fish in shallow water,
right,
back in the sticks, because the lake just came up, 12 feet, 12, 13 feet in a week. So they were letting out 2,000 cubic feet a second into this lake, and only like...
They still filling it? Or they closed
it? No, they closed it. They only did it for 1 week.
So okay.
A little bit over a week, but not too much, you know. So that raised up the lake a little bit, like I said, 12, 14 feet,
yeah,
somewhere in there. I don't know what a percentage is by the foot. I just kind of counted it as a foot. But it's a good thing, though. We needed some water in here because our lake in June 1st was 100%.
Right.
And then it went down to September, 50%. So, boy, it's a lot of change for the fish. So, you and I talked about the weather earlier, mm-hmm. about what's happening at Bartlett. And it's happening at all our lakes, guys. It just isn't Bartlett. It's Roosevelt. It's Pleasant. It's Alamo.
Right.
All the local lakes. Dave and I were talking about the change in weather. And that's huge.
It's been dramatic.
Oh, dramatic. Here we had temperatures of 85 degree water temperatures. And then all of a sudden it got cold. Those temperatures dropped to 75. Then we really got cold.
Got a fish.
Oh, good. Yeah. Do you notice how you got that? Tell us how you caught that fish.
I caught that fish because I was pulling out a backlash and it was just sitting.
Just sitting there. Well, that's a nice one. Look at this. Nice. Yeah. That's a good one, buddy. Look at that.
Look at that.
You got him. Look at that.
Nice little Bartlett bass.
Yeah. It's fun catching these little guys, you know.
Absolutely.
So you changed baits, didn't you?
I did. We went to the spinner bait.
you went to the spinner bait. And you're using a copper blade and a silver.
We have a little
trailer on there, which is okay. Gotcha.
Yeah. So we got the gold color willow. Got a little silver Colorado, and then a shad shaped trailer.
So, what just happened to you? You guys that fish and you're beginners. When something like this happens, he's peeling out line. He's got a little backlash. And that thing sunk in about 15 feet of water.
Yep.
Okay? Then you started reeling, bam, you got hit. So that transition from up there from the first 5 feet, the sun's up, they're right. Moving out.
Yep.
And they might be in that lower. So what we'll do now is we'll throw it out, we'll bring it out, we'll let it fall down to 10, 15 feet. And then the fish got a little bit bigger than mine, but you got one.
Right.
The important thing is you caught a fish. You know, we're gonna have to start the clicker now because I got a good fisherman on the boat. You know, so
we'll see. I'm a little rusty.
Yeah,
been a minute.
Yeah, good job. So I'm gonna cast it out. I'm gonna reel it just in case there's one, and then I'm just gonna let it dive. You do the same thing. Let's see if we can repeat, and we'll have that pattern. Then we can move anywhere on the lake, and that pattern will stay the same. We'll get them in 10, 15, 20 feet of water.
Absolutely.
We'll just try that and see. Now you're dead to me. You like drop shot and worm fishing, but mm-hmm. I'm going to make a spinnerbait guy out of you. There is a real good bite in the morning, but
right.
You got to get here when it's dark. You know, it's the first hour, and a lot of guys get here early, but you still can catch them. And it's now 8:40, so we've only been fishing for like 15 minutes, 20 minutes, so not even that long. And we caught two. So we're going to catch it, throw it by the bank, reel it slow, let it go down, reel a little bit more, let it go down. Now, granted, guys, I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, well, if I let it sink, I don't want to lose it. You got that out of your system. You lost that jackhammer already, so what the heck?
Absolutely.
Spinnerbaits are a little bit cheaper.
Well, if you lose it, no big deal. You just come down to Copper State Tackle or go online at copperstatetackle.com and we'll take care of you.
Yeah, what's the code for the discount on Copper State if they mention my name?
If you saw it on this video or you know Gary, it's Gary10. We'll give you 10% off online. Or just mention Gary in the store, and we'll give you 10% at the register.
Wow, that pays for your tax and everything.
Tax plus a little bit, yeah. Not to mention our amazing prices.
Oh, yeah. Well, your store is really loaded with all the name, state-of-the-art lures, fishing poles. You know, if you guys are after something really, really nice, you're going to find it.
We got from the basic necessities all the way up to JDM, expensive thing.
Wow.
Rock fooled me there. A little rock fish.
Oh, did it?
Yeah,
that's what we want to do. We want to hit these boulders. Now, you're using a little bit heavier spinnerbait than I am. I'm using a 3/8. You're using a 1/2 ounce. So this is going to sink a little bit more than mine.
Yeah. Which is right now, as nice as I'm feeling all the rocks, so I know I'm making that bottom contact. I'm going to slow roll it.
So on your spinnerbait, Do you know the brand name of that? What is, do you know?
This
what
is
it looks like good looking.
Well, a lot of times I'm throwing that light wire Gary spinnerbait.
Oh yeah.
We got these new spinnerbaits into the shop made by Bizbaits.
Bizbaits. Show that to the camera.
You got one
willow leaf and one Colorado on there, which is good. I like that.
Yeah.
I fish those a lot, and it's a half ounce.
It's a half ounce. The head comes through a different kind of cover pretty good. And then it's got a Gamagatsu hook. So it's not a heavy wire, but it's not a light wire. Good in between.
That's probably an old 50 wire. So it's a heavy duty.
That's what it seems like.
And it'll never break. The most we've caught on ours is 35 bass on a skinny wire. So I'm using 029.
Okay. Yeah.
And 030. You know, but we make them all the way up to 1 ounce. Matt just ordered 25 of spinnerbaits, 1 ounce.
Really?
He just took second place at Lake Havasu.
Yeah.
And I'll tell you what, that guy is good on a spinnerbait up there, and he runs into the cages, but he does lose a lot of them, but we custom make them for Matt. He wants a certain blade, the first one, the second one, different colors and stuff. So
Matt's Mr. Spinner Blade. Didn't he get his Arizona record on a
he did.
Spinner
Blade?
Canyon Lake. Spinner bait at Canyon?
He did. We'll just kind of keep moving. Folks, one thing you got to learn about is don't poke around when you're fishing. Keep moving. You know, find those fish. You know, we're both hammering the shore. We're both hammering. Sometimes, like, you just hit that rock. Sometimes, as you start to reel it, they'll nail it.
Yeah. That's usually when I get bit.
Yeah.
Feel a big rock get stuck, just kind of ease it over, and then hit the other side, and boom, fish. I have that program. There it is.
Again?
Yep.
Right by the boat, too. There you go. Whoa, you're taking drag. Mm-hmm. Nice. Always leave about 5 feet of line out when you flip them in. That you'll break your rod if you have one. So just kind of leave 4 or 5 feet. Nice. Look at that. Dave comes through. So the half ounce is getting you down on the bottom more than my little 3/8.
Yeah.
Show this guy on camera how that was hooked. Right there perfectly in the top of the lip.
Yes. Nice healthy little fella.
Now they are healthy. So see, guys, you can't adjust about the time. You could come out here, once you get the pattern down, you come out here at 9 o'clock, mm-hmm. 8, 9, 10 o'clock, and everyone's struggling, not catching any fish.
Absolutely.
You just gotta figure it. The neat thing about bass fishing, Dave, and you'll agree, is figuring out the bite.
Yeah.
It's just figuring it out, what those things. Now that one hit real close to the boat. You know, we're in 22 feet of water, and you were just letting that thing go down, you know.
Yeah.
I'm using a little bit lighter one. You know, 3/8, but I'm just letting it go down too. Now we're throwing a long cast now, so I'm just gonna let that go 10 feet from the shore. With a 90 degree angle, 10 feet from the shore is gonna land in 9, 10 feet of water.
Yep.
So I'm on the bottom, so I'm gonna start there.
Look at that, kids. That's where your geometry comes in handy.
Yeah. Always look at the terrain, what you're fishing in, and how steep a bank you're fishing mm-hmm. in. My idea when we start using plastic, I tell my customers, don't throw it to the shore. The fish are in 10 feet of water.
Right.
I want you to throw it 8, 10 feet off the bank so it hits them on the head. And then even if you're a rubber worming, you know.
So what are we doing now, Gary?
So we're just going to throw, and like I said, your spinnerbait fish you caught were in, what, 10, 15 feet of water?
Yeah.
Because you let that sink.
A little deeper.
Well, that gives us a little hint right now that those fish are going to be down 10, 12 feet.
Gotcha.
So we don't want to cast it up on the bank. I believe, you know, some guys believe that they'll cast it on the bank and then they'll just pull it out to the fish. I like to cast it where they are in 10 feet of water, let it hit them on the head and cause them to react on that bait.
Be a little more efficient too.
So you fished a lot drop shot. Doesn't matter if you drop shot. When you cast out, 90% of the time, if there's a fish there or two fish, one of them's going to bite it.
Right.
How many times have you cast it and you get bit right away? Right?
Yeah, absolutely. Right? A lot.
So a lot.
Yeah.
In fact, most of our bites that way. They're not. So I'll cast more. I train my guys when they're fishing with me. Cast it out 10, 12 feet from the boat. We'll let it hit the bottom. We're going to give it a little bit of work it a little bit. Okay. You don't want to pull it a foot or two at a time because crawdads don't do that. They just kind of go slow. You know how they crawl?
Right.
Or they just kind of move slow. So we want to just move that right, real slow on the bottom.
We're just going to kind of creep it along, keep bottom contact.
Exactly. Later on, we can get into that bite where they'll grab it. We can shake it more, but in the morning like this, we want to just, you know, just kind of pull it along.
Gotcha.
And then, now the bite's going to be two ways. We're either going to tick it.
Right.
Hit them on the first tick. Because they won't come back to the second.
That's right.
Okay, this is hard for my customers to do. 90% of them will not set the weight.
Yeah.
So I have to combat that by either moving that weight forward and put up some bobber stoppers on it.
Okay.
I'm only using a little Carolina rig like this.
Right.
And the reason is, when that fish takes your bait, he's taking your tungsten, mm-hmm. your hook, and your brush hog in his mouth.
Right.
Now you got to jerk that to get that weight out of his mouth and that hook to hit him on the top yet. Correct? Right.
Yep.
Okay, so you can see why it's important to set the hook. And I mean, you got to really snap it. It's not like really rear back like Bill Vance. It's just pop, you know. So. We're still down by the dam, by the spillway, you know, where the power line
right.
and stuff. We're just going to throw it out. We're going to bump it two or three times. We're going for that reaction bite of falling on their head. And we're going to move it a little bit. If there's one there, I'm going to bite it. We're just going for aggressive fish is what we're trying to do. And it's not, sometimes they'll grab it and just swim with it, and it'll just get heavy.
Right.
So on that, I just start reeling like this, and when my rod bends over, whack, I hit it. That's a little bit harder to get it. So we'll see what happens. We'll just cover a little bit of water. We got a little breeze that just started, which is good. The breeze is real good. So we're in 17 feet of water. Covering a lot of water right now. If we don't do any good here, we're going to go point fishing.
There we go.
So I always tell my customers on the videos, you watch all the videos.
Absolutely.
If you don't know where to fish and you can't catch fish like on a cup like this, go to the point.
Find a point.
We got a big point coming up here. So I just wanted to start on the side of this because I always catch fish in these big old boulders. Take them.
Right.
You know. Fishing on a stingy lake like today.
Barlett bass.
1 pounder, huh? Right in the top of the lake. So, like I said, guys, if you're fishing, you get that little tiny tick, that whole bait is in his mouth. I mean, you're talking the tungsten, the weight, the brush hog, the hook. And he doesn't have that big a mouth, so you got to get him on the first hit. So what we're doing, guys, is fishing. This is our bait fish right there, that big glob right there. But if you look at the little, there's one swimming there, and there's one swimming there, and there's some swimming there. And they're just going under the shad. So it's no wonder you're not catching them, because they're filling up on shad way out here in 23 feet of water. So, but what I do is I'll let that brush hog go or worm go down underneath the shad. And then I'll tease them. I'll just sit there and jiggle my rod down there, and then I'll just let it sit for a minute and tease them into biting. Let me show the audience what I'm doing. I make these new little baits, guys. I can come to you. And it's just a little underspin like this. And it's a 5150 Morning Dawn Money Shot worm. You can see the little spinner on there. So I was jiggling it up and down. And I was telling David I started making these things. So let's give it another try. And I'm always trying different things. Let's give this a try and see if we can hook another one.
Yeah, so we had a good day today. We fished for 4 hours. Started strong, kind of tailed off there at the end, as you guys saw. But what were we using, Gary? How were we fishing?
You know, we started out with spinnerbaits and chatterbaits. And the chatterbait got lost pretty quick. So we donated a $22 chatterbait.
Yeah.
So we put on some skinny wire spinnerbaits. And you were using one of your spinnerbaits from the store.
Bizbait spinnerbait.
Okay. So we caught a few on that. Not very many. 3 or 4.
Yep.
And then we went to brush hogging. And you never throw brush hog, so I wanted you to learn my technique of brush hogging, and we caught
three or four of that.
Yep.
And then we tried drop shotting with 5150 worms.
We had some drop shotting, got a couple, didn't get them filmed, but you know, I got a couple. Jay, cameraman, actually got them. That's why.
Yeah, we let him fish.
That's why nobody saw it. Right. We'll plug a picture in here of that fish. And but yeah, it was a great time. I appreciate getting out in the sun, having fun, getting to fish with Gary.
Hey,
that was amazing.
These guys are gonna have a lot of information. I'm telling you what, guys. We talked about the water coming up. We talked about the air temperature. We talked about the water temperature dropping.
Yep.
10, 15 degrees. We talked about the fall, the winter.
Yep.
I mean, we had so much subject in there while we fished and caught fish.
Absolutely.
So you won't get bored seeing this, but you new guys that are just new to fishing, this is going to be great to you. You guys that fish a lot, it's probably old stuff with Texas rigging and drop shot and stuff like that. But the new guys, you will be interested in this.
Everything you saw in the video is available in Copper State Tackle and online at Copper State CopperStateTackle.com, and if you punch in Gary10, you get 10% discount, or just mention in store you saw it with Fishing with Gary, and you'll get that 10% off also. But yeah, had a great time.
Yeah.
Appreciate it, Gary. It's always great to see you.
Thank you. About time we got out.
Right.
It only took a whole year.
Later.
Hey, thanks for watching Gary Senft Fishing Arizona.